kids in case someone comes to your door. Instead of getting some young dude just wants to flash and have a gun, you know, right. He'd know how to hand pick all the right plaintiffs and get them filing cases. And then he'd go to Article 1 here, which is going to be all Republican majority, it looks slim Republican majority, and say, the people are going to be suing the government and blaming you, and I can do it by administrative order and get you out of the hot water, and then be more likely to maybe let them do it, so they wouldn't have to legislate it. Then I said, well, if they still won't help him out at that point, then he can go ahead and do it while the plaintiffs, the court system's really slow. It'll probably take 1 or 2 or 3 years for these cases to matriculate, people wanting the windmills and the clean water and the...
Yeah, that's a shame that it takes that long.
Yeah, well, there's what, a long line to start with, and then they got to give so many days for the people to respond to each other. Yeah. And yeah, it moves slow. The justice moves slow. But if he has it on in there, if matriculating, then he can go ahead and do it, even though it's not the law yet. I guess the logic is, his job is to carry out the law. But if they fail to make a law that's necessary for him to uphold the Constitution, that's a sin of omission. Just like there's sins of commission, there's sins of omission. Like the parable in the Bible where the king invited the people to the wedding feast and nobody came, and he got angry, so he told his servants, go out and round up everybody, have them come. And so people showed up, and then the king goes to this one and says, where's your wedding dress? You got, this is a wedding. The guy didn't know what to say, so the king said, you know, you're out of here. Whereas if the guy had the wedding dress, or had he failed at least to have the presence of mind and say, you know, I'm here, take, eat, this is my body, or something. You know, he could say, that's my wedding dress. I have the intention that I'm here with a good faith. Then the king probably would have said, well, that's good enough for me. You may not look good, but your heart's in the right place. Yeah. So he had the sin of omission. He didn't think to in the wedding spirit.
Right.
So Obama says to Congress, you guys aren't thinking in the spirit of the wedding. You don't have your wedding dress on in your mind. You may have suits on. And I have to do these things in order to uphold the Constitution, because the technology and the people are moving so much faster than the Congress is. And if I don't do these things, the U.S. is guilty by sin of omission. So you're blaming me for doing stuff you haven't passed laws for yet, but I'm blaming you for not passing laws yet to uphold what the people are doing to be consistent with the Constitution. Now let Chief Roberts try to figure this out. You guys are going to vote in the Senate. I'll probably lose. Hang me. Crucify me. I'm at least bringing this to light. I'm taking control. I'm the chief executive officer. And the people are trying to get the same word to you. They're filing an Article 3, but it's going to be a couple of 3 years before their cases all arrive. We have been working with them. Our legal aid, the Attorney General's office, Holland, Florida, Bangladesh, international criminal courts coming after you for reckless governing. And I'm in here trying to save your butt before these cases arrive, and in the world opinion, the U.S. is found guilty. So if you want to find me guilty before the world finds you guilty, I am but a warner. You know, hang me. And he lights up a cigarette and said, Mitch McConnell, you sold me this cancer stick from Kentucky. All I'm trying to do is put $1 trillion in the bank for renewable energy for my daughters and your daughters. Which is worse? Hang me. Headlines around the world. Obama says, hang me. All the fundamentalists and the Islam out there beheading people. Wow, they got a president that said, hang me.
Yeah, but they don't think that way. I think we're just a bunch of pushovers.
Yeah, exactly. And if we finally got a president that went up there and said, I'm no pushover. I got 2 years left. I've been loyal to my party. We got still got a mess. I gave you 6 years to straighten out this list. I put $1 trillion in the bank with the U.S. military had to push the buttons to do it because the Mint knows the Constitution. I tried to explain to the Mint that your failure to pass laws,
unfortunately, if you would do that, Republicans and the Democrats together would probably spin it in such a way, make him sound like a fool for doing everything he did. You know?
I don't know. You mean?
Because he's a lame duck president, and they're going to want to get their own band in there. And
they got. Yeah. Okay. They might try to make him look like a fool.
Yeah. So they can get somebody else lined up. It's just.
Well, that's kind of
sick and appalling. You know, I'm 66 years old, and I've followed politics probably for the last 40 years anyhow. I didn't care a brass ass when I was 20.
Yeah.
You know, you just don't care. And even at 30.
Well, you got to live your life a little bit and learn about things before you can decide the fate of 7.5 billion people. You're supposed to get some real world experience.
So now you got... You didn't even hear of Obama. He just come up from out of nowhere.
Dick Durbin groomed him, brought him up. Dick Durbin's been picking the Democratic presidents for a while.
Yep.
Now his office is right next to Lisa Murkowski from Alaska, where I lived for 13 winters.
You liked it up there?
Yeah, until the darkness started to get to me. It's,
really?
The winters are really dark.
Kind of depressing.
Yeah, and it got a little small. A lot of new people start arriving, and there's not that much private land. It's a lot of federal land up there.
Yeah, I went up there on vacation once for a couple of weeks.
Southeast, or?
I went on a tour.
Uh-huh, inland water
passage. I got on a cruise ship. Vancouver.
Yeah.
Vancouver, but
Seattle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Seattle area.
Yeah.
Not Seattle, but anyhow.
Yeah.
And we went up and took a bus up to Fairbanks. Then we took a train from Fairbanks back down towards.
That's Susitna Valley. Yeah. Sitka. Amchitka.
Towards that, and then we went through all that. It took 2 weeks in doing it, but we didn't do it in the winter.
The summers are hyper, huh?
Yeah.
All that daylight.
That was pretty nice.
Yeah, I loved it as a kid, and I just
I don't know if I'd want to live up there. Like you said, you know, you have to prepare all summer for all winter.
Yeah, there are two seasons in Alaska, this
unless
winter and last
city
winter.
Dweller.
Yeah, there's two kinds of Alaskans now, you're right. Yeah, there's the indoor ones and the outdoor ones.
Yep.
Oh, you'd like it in Alaska, huh, Mekkah? You chase the bears in the woods?
And now my sister, she's down in the villages in Florida. She went down there about 4 years ago. So she's going further south. I went down to Key West last year at this time on vacation, and I don't know if I want to live down there or not. It's a strange place.
It's country music and drug smuggling.
Yeah.
Our national security office there, the Jamaican Mafia, Susan Rice.
Yeah.
Can you say hi?
Sure, it's good, perfect, be friendly, Mekkah. Yeah, I wonder what. That's being confident. Good dog. You're not going to be intimidated.
Look at this.
Yeah, Mekkah loves to play tag, sort of. You're it. But Obama might be able to preempt these guys from making him look like a fool, because like the IMF, with their SDRs, secure drawing rights, would like to be able to mint up another tranche themselves for like an IMF no-fault sea-level insurance fund from each nation according to their GDP to each nation according to their loss of shoreline. So they could put tens of trillions of these SDRs and say, okay, we're dividing them up between our 185 members in proportion to what you already have. So everybody's going to get more, and it's not going to change the balance. Everybody's, but you know, they're separate from your other SDRs. You can't be drawn on them, except as the sea level goes up, then you got to take from these and give to the ones that are losing their land. And then they can draw money against that so their people can move inland and relocate. And
well, there's nothing to about the sea level.
We can desalinate 1% of the sea and increase the amount of fresh water by 10 times. 1% change of sea, I don't know how much that could affect the sea level.
1% of the sea is a lot.
Yeah, 10 times is all the fresh water that we have. But if you take all the water we have and put it in a ball, next to the earth, it's about as big as your sunglasses, one lens is to your whole body. Same for the air, it's not much more.
Yeah, they're hunting for somebody.
Yeah, walking around with dogs and helicopters. It's blue, you think it's a police or is it news? Hard to tell. One time I walked across the reflecting pool there and a bunch of Boy Scouts were on the other side and this helicopter just flew up like where the Botanic Gardens is about, came over looking at it. The Boy Scout said, how come you walked through the reflecting pool? I said, well, if you can't walk on the water, you might as well walk through the water to draw attention to your cause. So they all liked the idea, and no one got in hot water. Germany's generating 40% of all their energy from renewables now. They're the masters.
Along the Ohio River, and there's only one hydroelectric dam in my area, and we have all these dams up through there. They could be producing electricity for everybody, but they don't. They'd rather burn coal. So Obama's shutting it down pretty fast.